Welcome to a very different episode of Headbangers Ball. It takes quite a lot to get me out of bed at 6:30 in the morning. Tonight is a very, very dangerous edition. For one, we're going to be meeting our Mission Megadeth winners, Krista and our friend Linda. We're also going to be hanging out with the guys from Megadeth, but that's not the most dangerous part about it. We're also going to be going skydiving. So it's not just the look of being tired that you see in my face right now. It's a look of being very, very scared. And of course, we've got 3 hours of great videos. So join us for a very death-defying episode of the Headbangers Ball with Megadeth. Ricky Rackman here with the guys in Megadeth and with Krista Mathurn, who's the winner of the Mission Megadeth contest. Right now we're here in Hollywood and we're getting ready to go to Paris Valley.
Skydiving.
I'm having a hard time talking right now.
I'm scared right now.
Scared is the understatement of the year. We're about to go skydiving now. You've done this before, right? Tons of times.
Si, senor.
And you like it?
Yes.
And you're going to do it again?
Many more times.
This time, I'm going to. So it could be the very last episode of Headbangers Ball, so.
Don't get your hopes up.
Oh, thanks. Right now, we're going to go to a video. Here is Extreme with Get the Funk Out.
Last time you'll see Ricky alive.
Goodbye, Hollywood. Goodbye, Jack Mulhall and Shelly Winters. Bye, Shelly. Ricky Rackman here with Dave Mustaine for a Mission Megadeth edition of Headbangers Ball. And I did the first step. I got on the bus. And as we get ready to pull up to this place, I'm not too sure. I will get off the bus. I think we're going to leave it at that. I'm really not too sure about how I feel. That'll be the second step, getting off the bus. I don't know how I feel about definitely jumping off a plane. See, there's certain feelings you can't express on TV right now. I mean, you skydived a couple times. I mean, a lot of times, right?
Right, right.
And you're into it.
Yes.
I mean, do you remember what it was like your first time?
Yeah, I remember. I can't explain it right now because there's a lot of expletives that would be useful that you're going to end up beeping out.
Uh-huh. Because you guys haven't seen all the whimpering I've been doing before. I mean, I'd like to just come off and say I'm the real cool guy and this is going to be real cool, but I'm scared to death right now. But I mean, this is, now the place that we're going to is like one of the best premier skydiving places, right?
In the entire world, this is the number one facility for skydiving. It's the safest. There's nothing that... How safe? I'm still alive, and as far as tandeming goes, zero accidents.
But I'm not going to do tandem. I'm going to do the whole course, and I'm going to jump out. We'll see. As of now, we'll see. There's still time.
No,
we'll
park
see.
Right here.
Anyway, stick around. Headbangers Ball with Megadeth, and Dave will be jumping out of a plane. We'll see if I do it.
And then we're there.
Well, I got off the bus, so I guess that's a start. Anyway, we're here with Megadeth at Paris Valley, which is a desert kind of by Lake Elsinore, California. And let's change the subject from the skydiving for a second, please. Now, about Hangar 18, I understand, would you explain what Hangar 18 is? It's pretty interesting.
Nick, you're in. What are we talking about?
Hangar 18.
Hangar 18, what do you want to know?
What it is.
Hangar 18 is a government alien base that holds aliens and artifacts and UFOs and you name it. And we're here today.
And there's proof. There's proof that Hangar 18 does exist, ladies and gentlemen.
They look kind of like this.
They look a little bit like Gary Coleman, but there is Hangar 18. It does exist.
Those are actually just photos from our video shoot.
Right.
So anyways, I guess maybe we could... They've never found Hangar 18, is that correct?
No.
So maybe we could go. So maybe we could look for it instead of going skydiving or something like that.
No, we're going skydiving.
Go searching through the desert for Hangar 18. Anyways.
You're not getting out of this. We're going skydiving.
We're trying. I feel like I'm catching a bit of a cold also, and I understand jumping isn't good with a cold.
It's good for your sinuses. It'll open them right up.
Here in Paris Valley and sort of by Lake Elsinore, California. It's the Headbangers Ball, the Mission Megadeth edition of the Headbangers Ball, and Dave is currently getting ready to skydive, so I thought it was a perfect time for me to kind of escape, maybe miss the plane. and with the other guys in Megadeth. And we're about to do the Ball Buster, but first let's talk a little bit about next week's show.
Cat House Show.
Yeah. See, how did we swing that one?
Every time I'd go to Ricky's club and like I'd want to get in for free because I didn't want to pay, he'd always like go, "Hey man, will you play at my club?" I'd go, "Yeah, call my manager. Anyway, let me in, okay?"
That was about 3 years ago.
That was about
ago.
3 years ago, so finally I guess he got tired of letting me into his club, so now we're going
to
play.
And you guys get to come along too. So it's going to be fun because, for one, you guys never really played in Hollywood, have you?
Actually, yeah, we kind of like did things backwards. Most bands like play the clubs in Hollywood trying to, you know, get more popular, and it's like we never did play a Hollywood club. And
shows you where we're going.
And also, so you know, the club is like really, really small, and we couldn't tell people that they were playing under the name Megadeth, so you guys are going under the name...
Vic and the Rattleheads.
Vic and the Rattleheads.
We gave it away.
Which pretty much any Megadeth fan is going to know anyway.
Is Hollywood still alive?
We'll find out next week. But right now it's time to pick the Headbangers Ball Buster of the Week. And first we'll show last week's winner, and then we'll show who they're going up against. And they're going up against this time South Gang with Tainted Angel. The number to call is 1-900-370-010. Do you know how much each call costs?
50 cents.
That's it. 50 cents you can call. And here's last week's winner.
Well, those are jump boots, so you're
they
not
are.
Getting out of this.
No, yeah, well, considering I always thought these were skydiving boots, but of course I looked around and I'm the only person in this entire place that's got boots. Everybody's wearing sandals or tennis shoes.
I'm Dave from Megadeth.
This is Marty.
We're just chilling down here in Paris Valley. We got rid of Ricky finally somewhere up in the sky, flying, getting kicked out of a plane. But anyway, now that he's not around, Marty and I are here to hold down the fort, as you can plainly see. We're trying to reenact Rio here, actually, and just kind of like chill by the pool.
Well, remember Rio? This is nothing like it.
So, anyway, Marty and I are not the skydivers. I know Dave's like really into this. This is like his little baby, so it's like, we'll let him do his thing here. Actually, I remember when Ricky was supposed to go skydiving when we were doing the Hangar 18 video, like around Christmas time, and he chickens out, and I think the big thing was when Dave told him that they have chutes for women down here, he decided to come down here and check it out. So, anyway, got a new video coming for you, Sepultura Dead Embryonic Cells.
Headbangers Ball is here in Paris Valley, Desert, California. We're here at, I guess this is called the Paris Valley Skydiving Center. This is Steve Rom and Dave Mustaine, and you're a jump master here, which means you teach people like us how to jump out of an airplane.
Lots of them.
And even a person like this, you were there on his first jump.
What, even a person like this?
Yeah, like him. I mean, an experienced skydiver.
We're going to be on yours, too.
Now, I got a question. I mean, I'm really, really, really nervous right now. And he's been kind of giving me a hard time throughout the show. Now, how was he on his first jump?
The truth, for anybody. Very, very calm. Very, very calm. Very relaxed. Not the slightest bit of fear.
But nervousness is something that's
very
normal,
very
right?
$2.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, how many jumps have you done?
I've made 1,800 jumps in the last 5 years.
1,800
and...
And you're fine?
30-something.
Because there's a lot... I mean, how dangerous is skydiving?
I mean, it's perceived as a lot more dangerous than it is. It's not any worse than skiing or motorcycle riding by any means. It is a high activity sport, and it's one where you need to be responsible for yourself. But if you're responsible for yourself, you follow basic rules, you're safe. Okay. One of the sayings I got here is, remember when sex was safe and skydiving was dangerous? That's one of my favorite ones.
With that, let's go into a video. Here is Dio with Rainbows in the Dark.
Like I said, nothing compares to this. Not sex, not drugs, nothing.
The landing was beautiful, man. Yeah. Here, you want to talk real quick?
Yeah, sure.
Real quick. Well, you saw him up there. That was him. No stunt person. Dave, you look. This was your first time jumping completely solo without a... What was it like? I mean, I'm like shaking watching.
It was pretty cool. I tried to do a somersault, but I think I got a little bit overwhelmed. Did a lot of spins, a lot of turns, a little forward movement. This canopy's a lot smaller than the one I've been using, so I started doing my turns.
I noticed that you were up there doing some 360s, and you got, like, really spinning.
Yeah, the first time I did that, I kind of had to make sure I wasn't peeing, but...
Uh-huh. Were you?
No, well,
okay.
Don't think so.
You did a perfect landing. I mean, you were, like, that was there. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Now it's my turn.
Eat your hearts out.
We're back here at the Bat Plane, the Ultralight in Paris Valley.
finally talked Christy into going up for a ride. You ready
I'm
for this?
I'm not going up in one of these.
Yeah, you're trying to weasel out of your skydive.
Well, you
already.
Know, it's really, really windy, and they say it's very dangerous to jump out of a plane when it's really windy. And right now, look at this. Look at my hair. Ladies and gentlemen, this is windy, and I might just have to do ground reports today. Look at this wind. Would you jump? You wouldn't jump, would you? They wouldn't jump.
I wouldn't jump.
See?
So you guys having fun or what?
Oh, yeah, having a blast.
Cool.
What these things are, these are like hang gliders with engines on them.
Yeah, actually, when I went up in it, it was kind of like a lawnmower with wings, you know, so it's like, we'll see. I had a good time up there, so hopefully she'll have a good time.
Of course, it wasn't as windy.
She brought along the special feature that every tourist should have. Shorts, the whole bit here, so.
It's very windy. Much too windy
to
jump out of a plane.
The pilot, whenever he comes. Here he comes right now. He's coming back. We'll see what happens.
Well, Chris is going to go, so you have a good time, and if this wind doesn't die down, I'll just do a ground report. You understand. You wouldn't jump out of a plane.
Everybody's getting their wings today.
There's some wind, ladies and gentlemen.
They're going to have fun. This is it. There they go.
You know what? That does look kind of scary.
That looks real scary.
Check main.
Okay.
Ready, set, go.
Okay, good, fine. Just hop on out of there.
It's easy even on the carpet. Welcome back to the Headbangers Ball. Ricky Rackman here, and I'm sorry, I'm just having a hard time concentrating. The thought of being 13,000 feet up there and jumping now. I went through a six-hour course, probably because it means 6 hours I can stay on the ground. But if you want to do, there's another way to do this. And Nick here has done that way, and it's called tandem jumping, which takes, I guess, a 20-minute class, and you're about to go through that class. So it's a great way for some of you that want to jump out of an airplane just to kind of jump right into it.
And you can't be, so anyway. You can't be a full man like Ricky. You can be a half man like me and do the
or
tandem.
Twice a man like Dave, who's jumping out all by himself.
All by himself, yeah.
Or is that just crazy? But anyways, I mean, Heather. How do you feel? I
feel like it could be my last day, but then again, I feel like it's not, and it could be, but I won't be, so I should be, but I'm gonna be. So there you have it.
But it's pretty. It's you guys
I
gotta you guys gotta
all.
Try this. But he's gonna go through the tandem course pretty soon. But right now, while we're prepping, and I gotta use the restroom a couple times again. And why don't you tell us about this video we're going to play?
Oh, we're going to play a video for you now called I'm the Man by Anthrax.
And if you jump, you are the man or the woman.
A life or death or something. And so I told Dave, he kept bugging me, dude, come down and skydive. I said, no, I ain't skydiving until the record's at 1 million copies. Then I'll skydive.
Did it hit 1 million?
No. And what am I doing here?
I know what I'm doing, man.
Okay, look, I look at this thing, I went through the course, the whole thing looks safe. I love the show, I want to do it for the show, but there's not a chance that I'm jumping out of an airplane.
Why'd we bring you here, Rick? Why'd you come down?
There's just not a, look, I mean, we're talking 13,000 people.
Oh,
danger is my business. Oh, my ankle. Wait a minute.
How was it?
It was incredible. I mean, you did it too. It was in.
It was
let
great.
Me tell you something.
This right here is the man who was never going to jump. Dave
ever.
Used to vibe him so hard. Now today he jumps.
Or did it?
It's back here at Ground Zero.
Yeah, we're here at Zero.
Grandfell.
It's all the way
it's
over here.
It's beautiful up there. It's incredible. There's absolutely no possible way. Whatever you think skydiving might be like, it's better.
And you
whatever
know what?
You think it might be like, you're wrong. It's better.
I saw Hangar 18 on the other side of those mountains.
So if we go back up again, we'll get a little bit closer. And these people here at Paris Valley Skydiving Center kept us alive.
Thank you.
This place is great.
I'm gonna go find Hangar 18 right now. That's the whole reason we're here in the first place.
Keep them up there.
It's kind of like no practical use for this. It's just a sheer fun pleasure instrument.
Wings, everybody. And we're out here. I can hear myself talking. I can hear you. We're strapped in. We're ready to go. All right. I'm going to go find Hangar 18 right now. Marty, introduce the video. We're going to be out of here.
This is Marty from Megadeth. While Junior's out there looking for Hangar 18 somewhere, you guys are going to listen to the Skull Crusher of the Week, Are You Ready, from AC/DC. Check it out.
Absolutely exhilarating. Don't try this at home.
I'm Nick Menza.
I'm Dave Ellison.
I'm Marty Friedman.
And I'm Dave Mustaine, and we're from Megadeth, and we'd like to thank this week's Headbangers Ball Hangar 18 contest winners, Krista Mathurin and Linda LeConte. Did you guys have a good time?
Yeah, definitely.
Never did find Hangar 18, though.
No. I don't think it's out there.
These guys were supposed to look for it, and they didn't.
It's not in this state.
But they were searching in the ultralight. We'd like to tell you that we'll see you next week on Ricky Rackman's famous cat house on Headbangers Ball. And we'd like to thank the Paris Valley Skydiving Center for having us here and taking such good care of us. Until then,
see ya.
Arch, pull,
out.
I told you I was gonna stand this bad boy up. Yeah! Brought the ripcord back. Oh yeah, I'm sorry. This is Ricky Rackman from Paris Valley. I'll do a lot for the Headbangers Ball, obviously. Anyway, I'll see you next Saturday. We'll be at the Cat House. Megadeth will be playing live there. And it'll be crazy and it'll be dangerous, but in a different sense. I'm Ricky Rackman. Remember to keep one foot in the gutter, one fist in the gold. And your head's always above the clouds. I'll see you next Saturday as Headbangers Ball's at the Cat House live with Megadeth. Yeah!
Yeah.